All right, we are ready. Again, my name is Susie Wargen. I am your MC tonight. And since I did the Western Roundup last year, I kind of went Western Roundup a little bit again this year. So I've got a spirit sister out there that's wearing jeans. So that's why I'm not as dressed up. All of you look so beautiful tonight. So thank you all for looking so nice. So I want to bring up now one of Vaughn's good friends, Bradley Chubb, linebacker for the Denver Broncos, who is joining us virtually. So Bradley, I think we get him up on the screen here. There he is. Hey, Bradley, how are you?
Doing good. How y'all doing?
Bradley Chubb, ladies and gentlemen. All right, Bradley, can you see everybody?
I can see myself.
You can see yourself. Okay, well, there's lots of people here. We're at a beautiful hangar at Centennial Airport, the signature hangar. So it's really neat to be able to do an event tonight. Let me first ask you, how are you feeling? It's great to have you back. I know it's been two losses, but it's been really good to see you back on the field.
Yeah, it's been good to be back, feeling good, and just being around my team again. So I'm glad I could be on the field right now, doing as much as I can, and hopefully we could turn these losses into wins soon.
And the injury that you went through last year with your knee, you know, very similar, unfortunately, to our big host for this evening, Vaughn Miller. What have you talked to Vaughn about? How can you help him and also some of your other teammates? Cortland Sutton, we just found out today, same thing with an ACL. So now you are you're the master mentor as far as it goes with rehabbing that knee.
Yeah, I could just be there for him. I mean, just let them know I'm there for him and encourage them like they did me throughout my rehab process. And go out there and just make plays for him and show him that, like, you can come back from an injury and it's going to be nothing to it. So just try to be encouraging to those guys as much as I can and let them know I'm behind them 100%.
Bradley, talk about your relationship a little bit with Vaughn. And, you know, Vaughn does so much in this community. You guys all do so much in the community. And what your friendship means and also Vaughn's vision.
I mean, it means a lot because you see, like I'm saying, the person that Vaughn is off the field, he's, you know what I'm saying, he does all the good things on the field, but you see that he really cares about people and he, like, really takes time out of his day in order to, like, put a smile on other people's faces. So when you see a guy doing stuff great on the field and great off the field, it's just a complete package, and he's a great guy.
All right, any other message for our folks out here tonight? Bid often and bid high?
Yeah, bid high. Bid often and bid high. That's perfect.
All right, Bradley Chubb, appreciate your time tonight. Thank you very much, and we'll see you Sunday against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. That's Bradley Chubb, ladies and gentlemen. All right, thank you for that tonight. Now we have another couple of videos. We have some more special guests on video, one of them being Snoop Dogg, and then a special guest. So if you'll turn your head to the screen here.
Enjoy the rest of your night, and thank you for helping Vaughn's vision to provide kids with the gift of sight. Peace and love, Slick Rick.
What up, though? This is Big Snoop Dogg on behalf of Vaughn Vision. I want to give a shout out to everybody out there tonight. Vaughn, keep your head up. This is Big Snoop Dogg, man. Let's have some fun tonight. Hey, come on. What up, kids?
All right, Snoop Dogg and Slick Rick. All right, very good. Okay, so there's our special video guest. We are going to check in with Vaughn here in about 15 minutes. He is going to be with us virtually tonight. He's having a little trouble getting around right now, so it was very difficult for him to get here this evening, but we will have him virtually in a little bit. So enjoy another cocktail maybe or at your table, and we'll have that in about less than 15 minutes here. And make sure that you're looking at your phone and all the silent auction items, and also take a look inside that bidder card so you can see what the live auction items are, because we'll be doing that a little bit later on. Is everybody enjoying our wonderful salads? How about that? It's just so nice to be out, you know? And we're not making our own food and somebody else is making food for us, and it's just fabulous. So again, thank you for coming out tonight, a night to take flight for Vaughn's vision. And as mentioned, Vaughn, of course, suffered the ACL injury in training camp, and so we have he's not able to be here tonight. He's having trouble getting from kind of room to room right now after his surgery. So if I can have you turn your attention to the video screen, Vaughn has a message for us here tonight.
Hey guys, this is Vaughn Miller. You know, I had my surgery, and it was just extremely tough for me to make it to the event tonight. I appreciate all the well wishes, and I appreciate everybody understanding the process that I'm going through now. Thank you to Hero Practice Services and Champ Automotive and Subaru. I appreciate you guys for continuing to lead the pack and for continuing to support Vaughn's vision. We have a great team, But it's guys like you, it's guys like the board members, it's guys like everybody in attendance tonight that really make this thing go. I started Von's Vision back in 2012 after a year of just sitting back and thinking about what I could do. I was signing autographs, and I took my glasses off and I set them down on the table, and I was just like, hey, I'm gonna start a foundation to give back contacts, glasses, eye exams, everything to do with glasses back to kids in the community. And to see where it's grown 8 years later is truly unbelievable. I'm just as proud of Von's Vision and all the things that we do with Von's Vision as I am with playing football for the Denver Broncos. Winning Super Bowl MVP and starting Von's Vision are right there together with me when it comes to my career. So I appreciate all you guys. I appreciate everything that you guys have done to support and bring it to where it's at now. The kids that we have in our community need our help now more than ever this year. COVID-19 and all the other uncertainties that we have, they really need our help, and you guys could help out by donating and bidding on silent and live auction items. We all know Von's Vision event is crazy, and tonight is gonna be just the same. We have a lot of great things coming up for you guys. Be sure to check it out. You guys have fun. Enjoy dinner, and I'll check in on you guys in a bit. Thank you, guys.
All right, that's the man of the night, Von Miller, and I should correct, and thank you, Brandon. Von had the ACL injury. That's been a few years now, so it's the tendon in his foot. We just have, like, all these ACLs, and, gosh, there were 40-some injuries yesterday, I think, in the NFL, so it's hard to keep up with all of them. So we will hear again from Von, but at this time, I want to, now that we've heard from Bradley Chubb and Snoop Dogg and Von, I want to introduce some more celebrities that we have in here tonight in a fun segment with a little Q&A. And some of you wrote down some questions, and we appreciate that. We have gathered them from you. So please join me in welcoming Mark Schlereth, Carl Mecklenburg, and Ryan Harris, all former Broncos and well-respected members of our community, to the stage right now. Gentlemen. And I'm also going to treat myself a little bit here, because usually I'm the one that asks all these questions, but today I get to sit here and answer some. I don't know if BK will ask me any questions, but I'd like to bring up Brandon Cristall. He is the Broncos insider at KOA News Radio. You will hear him all throughout the week on KOA and also on our Bronco broadcast, and he is going to moderate the panel tonight. So, Ryan, you need to sit here. Sorry, you don't get to sit all by yourself. That's where Brandon sits, and then, and I'll sit right here, so... Brandon, take it away, and Mark and Ryan and Carl, get ready for questions.
This is fun to do. I've done a couple of events with some Hall of Famers at the Super Bowl, and it's guys like Rod Woodson and I'm trying to remember who some of the other ones were, but it's guys that all work in TV, and they're all better at this than I am. And I'm sitting with four people. Stink is one of the best radio hosts and TV analysts out there. Mech is one of the highest paid public speakers, maybe right below President Obama and President Clinton in the world. Ryan Harris has a radio show, and he's the color analyst at Notre Dame. And then Susie, in addition to being the sideline reporter, is also on the Fox every day for 6 hours. She's a great talk show host and great on TV. Nonetheless, they asked me to do this, so I'm going to ask some questions. And you guys have submitted questions. We're going to try to get through as many as we can. My question that I'm going to start with is kind of for each of you, but I'm going to let Stink kick it off, because you all have a similar perspective that you all love the Broncos, kind of for different reasons. You guys obviously playing there, Susie growing up here, and then covering the team. So, Stink, how hard was it, and I know this story, but not everybody out here does, when you got out of the league and you take your job in media to be critical of the team? And I know that at least one head coach took exception to some of your analysis.
I mean, get in line. The people who take exception to some of my analysis it wasn't hard at all. It was easy. I mean, I crossed over from being a player to being an analyst. And, you know, Mike Shanahan and I have a very special relationship. He was my head coach for 6 years. We went from head coach player to head coach media guy to mentor mentee. And I have spent so much time learning the game from Mike Shanahan. And when I first crossed over into the media business, we had some words over something that I said. And I told Mike at that point, when I signed a contract and left the Washington football team and came here to be a Denver Bronco, did you expect 100% effort from me? And he said, of course I did. And I go, then how could you know the integrity that I have and expect anything less than 100% in my new profession? Like, shame on you for even thinking that I would take it easy on you. As a matter of fact, I'm going to be a lot tougher on you than I am anybody else because you're my family. You're my football family. And from that moment on, we have had a very special relationship because that's just the way it goes. So I get everything I could possibly get out of my career and out of my body. I never cheated it. And that's just the way I'm going to approach work in general. So I never had any problem crossing over. It didn't bother me to tell the truth because it's just the way I operate.
Yeah, for you, Mac, who you're active on social media, I'm sure whenever you get stopped, people want your opinion on this version of the Broncos in a given year. You're interviewed all the time. So even though you haven't necessarily worked full-time in media like Ryan and Stink, you get asked about the Broncos a lot. So how tough is it for you knowing that someone say, hey, I ran into Carl Mecklenburg, and he told me that that guy really sucks? How hard was that for
Carl
you?
Carl doesn't do that.
No, but how hard was that for you to...
Carl's way nicer than me.
To guard against that or know that, for whoever meets you, because I've bumped into you in airports and stuff, they'll ask you a question. You have to probably toe the line, or do you not care?
I'm gonna be as truthful as I can. There's always reasons for what's going on in a football player's life. I don't have a problem saying, this guy made a mistake here, this guy made a mistake there. I'm not going to say somebody sucks because they're in the NFL. If they were in the NFL, they wouldn't suck, right? So, there's no question about that. But there's this team this year, for example, is just, it's young, and you don't have a preseason. All the injuries, we had five weeks of practice in Greeley, and it was full contact 2-a-days. And if you made it to the season, you were physically sound. You can make it through. Now they're putting guys out there. They don't know if they're physically sound or not. How are you going to find that out unless there's contact? And now there's contact, and they're falling like flies.
Well, so Ryan, for you, not only are you working here in town locally, you're also the color analyst at your alma mater, which some people may be fans of, the University of Notre Dame. Some people love to hate, but it's pretty highly, not scrutinized, but viewed, right? Notre Dame's the most popular college brand out there still. So your words are going to carry weight. So it's kind of a two-part question. In Denver with guys that you got off the playing field and you're being critical of your teammates at times. And then your alma mater, if they're losing games, you have to be honest. So how has that been for you?
Well, one of the things I learned when we won the Super Bowl, never apologize for high expectations. And one of the benefits for me, I came from Notre Dame, were the expectations to win a national championship. And at the Broncos, the expectation is to win a Super Bowl. And you can feel it in the locker room and everything you do. I've been on teams where literally they said, hey, let's make the playoffs and see what happens. You never even get close. So I talk about, hey, if you want to win a championship, these are the things you have to do. Now, if that's not what they want, that's not my problem, right? I have an expectation to be great. And if you want to be great, I know certain things specifically related to football that you have to do to get to that level.
And so then for you, Suze, somebody who grew up here, you work for CSU's broadcast for a long time. You love your Rams. And I know there's probably plenty of Rams fans out there. Buffs fans, too, and everything in between. Jayhawks. Go Vandals. Go Buckeyes, right? We're covered. Anyway, for you, though, Suze.
Brandon.
Go Gophers. God, Carl went to – I'm confusing him and Randy. Sorry. Apologies. I do that a lot. Go Gophers. But, Suze, for you, how hard is it for you to be critical of the teams you grew up loving?
It's kind of difficult because I did grow up loving them. And as far as the Broncos go, that was something my family every single Sunday in the 70s watching Carl. My dad loved Carl. He loved Steve Atwater and Steve Watson as we went on in the years. And so our families would have, their friends over, and then the kids, we would all go in the basement. We'd watch the games. So it's a dream come true to be on the sidelines for these games and to be able to cover it. But it's hard sometimes for me because it is hard when it's in your heart, when that's your team. And same thing with CSU, but I do think that there comes a point where it doesn't mean I'm not going to ask the tough question. You still have to ask the tough question, but I might not be as harsh as some of these guys, although Carl's never harsh. Carl's like such a gentle giant, and for those that watched him play in the 70s, I mean, holy cow.
And in the 70s, well, right? Or never.
Did you go to high school?
Well, 80s, did you watch him in high school?
No way.
I was like, damn, Carl, you're old.
No, Carl, what years did you play?
Carl and John were rookies
83?
Together.
83? Oh, I was thinking, okay.
Yeah, Carl and John came in together, 7 and 77. And soon enough, Carl will be in Canton with them as well. Right?
Wait, but you played in the... No, you didn't come in until 83?
83 through 94.
Yeah.
My favorite note on Carl Mecklenburg's career, and maybe one of the reasons you're not in the Hall of Fame yet, is that you started at all 7 positions on the defensive front, and that's, one, really hard to do, and two, you probably would have dominated at any of them if they would have just let you stay there, but every year they're switching you out. So I didn't have that as a question, but I guess I am curious... How fun slash challenging was that to switch every year, just about?
Well, yeah, Joe Collier was an amazing coach. Joe would identify what you were capable of and try to take advantage of that and help the team with that. To me, that's the sign of great coaching. He saw a linebacker when nobody else had seen that before. I'd never played linebacker in my life until my third year in the NFL. I made the Pro Bowl that year as an all-pro linebacker. And then got to the point where he was moving me around. Even inside of one game, I played all 7 defensive front positions a couple of times. So he put me where he thought the ball was going. And as a defensive player, that's where you want to be, right?
Yeah, so, you find the ball. So before I get to all these questions, there's a lot. I don't know if we'll be able to get through all of them. Something that you touched on, Carl, with the injuries. Susie mentioned all the injuries. Obviously, Vaughn dealing with the tendon in his foot. Then Cortland going down today. He's done for, or going down yesterday, done for the year. We got a bunch of guys on the shelf. Injuries are the main story right now in the NFL, even more so than COVID and all the protocols. So, Ryan and Mark, I'll ask you before we get to these cards. Do you agree with Carl that the lack of preseason, truncated off or no offseason and truncated training camp is the main reason these injuries are happening? Because I could make the case that a torn ACL is a torn ACL and it's fluky. Or a tendon snapping in your foot is fluky. Drew Lock's shoulder, he's getting hit. That's not because he didn't go to the preseason. Or maybe it is. Maybe if he was getting hit more, his awareness would be better. So would you agree with that?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things you got to do is you got to callus your feet and forehead in football. You know what I'm saying? So just think about if you were going to play basketball right now, you'd have to get used to your shoes. You get no time for that. And then, oh, by the way, guys like Carl and Mark are trying to kill you while you're doing it. So it's hard to adjust to that size, speed, and then also your physical preparation you need to do to be successful.
Yeah, I always think about it from a kinesthetic awareness standpoint. You know, that's one thing to run, one thing to cut on air in shorts and a t-shirt, and then it's another thing to do it while somebody's doing this to you. And so when you're battling that way and you put your foot down and you've got 300-pound man pushing you in some direction, that's a skill, that's an awareness aspect that develops over time. And when you don't practice and you don't hit each other and you don't do any of that, I do believe that contributes to the injuries. And I think it's been pretty apparent over the last several years as they continue to take practice and take, you know, contact out of a contact sport, we continue to see more soft tissue and tendon and ligament injuries.
And yeah. I think a lot of Achilles injuries right now, and that's got to be part of it too, because the Achilles is one of those things that really, I think, probably has to be built up, and that's what training camp helps and hitting, right? I mean, those scare me, the Achilles.
Yeah, I think it's all part of that, and I think that's, you know, part of, we've negotiated as players, we've negotiated contact out of a contact sport, we've negotiated ourselves out of $40 million facilities to work out in. And we pay $100,000 a year now to go work out on our own when there's a $40 million facility with cryovac machines and chiropractors and all the care in the world that you could possibly want just to get out of doing some things that are actually essential to being a football player. So there are a lot of things, but I'm old and I'm a curmudgeon, so that's just how I feel about that.
No, it is funny because based on when you guys played, Carl obviously going through maybe even some 3-a-days, and then Stink when you came along, and then even Ryan, you got to be looking at training camps these days. Even in a non-COVID year, thinking how soft these guys are. What's funny, too, though, about Susie is she works out more than any of the four of us up here. I can guarantee you that. And if you follow her on social, so when she chimes in about Achilles or anything else related to the body, I know that Susie's hitting it every morning because I see your Instagram posts. Let's get to some of these cards, though, because I want to try to fly through these. They're for mostly for you guys, but Susie, I'll figure out a way to drop them in for you as well.
These guys are more important.
Carl, this is for you. Who was the quarterback that you hated playing against? Ben at table 29 asked that question. So thanks, Ben. What quarterback did you despise going up against?
Wow. You know, anybody wearing a Raiders uniform?
They were losing 10-0 tonight. If
that's the easy answer, but there was, you know what? The fast guys, the guys that scrambled all the time, because then you had to keep your pass rush lane exactly right. And you couldn't go inside. You couldn't take any chances. So you really couldn't get any pressure. And then if you did, they'd run away from you anyway. So
sure. So you didn't play Randall Cunningham very much, but I imagine someone like that was tough to tackle. Stink. Pantuso with Calabria is at table 14, and they'd like to know, how many concussions have you had? And then why don't you add the caveat, how many overall surgeries, too, because that's always a fun number.
Concussions, I have no idea. Back in Carl and I's day, you just got dinged.
How many fingers?
Yeah.
Two. It's always two.
Yeah, it's always two. There was no real concussion protocol. I mean, I've seen trainers tape aspirins to things back in my day. That's going to help you get better. But I will tell you that there's probably not a game I ever played in there I didn't at least knock myself out for a second. Sure. You know, where I wake up on the ground going, wow, that was, you know, good. Or
you probably
stars.
Had some of those too, Carl, right?
Right. Oh, yeah. Yeah, all the time. So that was – but I listen, man, as far as that stuff is concerned, I do believe there is enough connectivity in the brain, there's enough plasticity in the brain to overcome a lot of the injuries, because I think your body's a great healing machine if you're using your brain. I think there's a lot of guys that get done – and don't have anything better to do, so they just sit around and they get stagnant, and that adds to some of the dementia problems and some of the overall brain issues. So I do think that there's part of that to how you live after you're done playing is a very important part to your mental wellness, your mental capacity, and your brain health. As far as surgeries, it turns out that football and surgeries are totally related. I had 29 while I was playing. And I haven't had one since I got done. So it is football. There's a direct correlation between football and getting injured. Huh. So you guys can talk about that amongst yourselves, you know, when you're outside of.
He did say 29 surgeries.
Yeah, 29 surgeries.
Yeah.
Carl, do you have a number that's that high or close to it?
18.
18.
Ooh,
so Ryan, you're probably the low man there, although your back's maybe trouble.
And thank you for turning that light down. Hot as hell. How y'all not sweating up here? I had 10 surgeries, 4 on my back. And 5 to save my leg below my knee, and 1 total toe replacement. So at one point in my career, halfway through my career, unable to walk upstairs.
Which
so
toe?
The big toe on the right foot.
Do you got like a plastic toe, or is it like a titanium toe?
Hey, it works. That's all I know for now. You know, shout out to Dr. Clanton at Vail Orthopedics.
You
there.
Set off the metal detector when you go through the...
Not yet, man. Not yet. But I'll tell you
what. What's it made?
Today, yeah. It don't move that well. And... to give an idea, and Vaughn's going through this right now, too, and all of us have done this with rehab, I was looking at getting an extra degree of bend, just 1 degree each week. So I had to do that for 33 weeks, and that's a tough process, too, going through that rehab, coming back and succeeding.
Yeah, I couldn't imagine. I'll keep my 10 toes, fingers crossed. Nate Standish is at table 35. He wants to know, Ryan, what was your favorite play of your career?
Wow, that's a great one. I got 2 that are tied. We were the only team to beat Bill Belichick twice in the same season when we won Super Bowl 50.
Yeah. Can I guess, is one of them in the snow?
One of them's in the snow, and I went out, and it's funny the thoughts you get in a game, right? I went out to pull. It was called 19 tackle pull, 19 truck. And I went out there, and then there's Malcolm Butler, who just a year before had gotten that pick to win the Super Bowl. I thought, oh, that's Malcolm Butler. And then, whoop, cut out his legs. And then I looked up, and C.J. Anderson was running right at me, so I had to slam my head down. He jumped over me. We scored a touchdown, won the game. And then later in that year, that was awesome. That was awesome. And then later in that year, we had a play called Cobra, quick strike. And when we played Pittsburgh in the playoffs, we knew that they celebrated a lot. So if we got to a, you know, got to have it situation, we're going to run a quick play. So Peyton starts screaming, Cobra, Cobra, on 4th down. And we run the run, and I block, and they always say, if you score with your man, you're going to score. So I'm in the end zone, and I look to where CJ's supposed to be, and he lands in the end zone. We're eye to eye just screaming at each other before the entire stadium, And then the stadium screamed, we won the game. That was awesome.
By my math, that was the only touchdown of that game, right?
It was.
Randy kicked five field goals. Do you guys have favorite plays that stick out to you before we move on to a couple more?
Yeah, I've got one. My first game ever as a linebacker. We're playing the Raiders, and Plunkett dumped this floater pass to Marcus Allen, and I did what I wasn't supposed to do, which was bite up. First game ever as a linebacker, came up, and I knocked him out. His eyeballs were doing this, and I was a linebacker. That's kind of what set the tone for the rest of my career.
Stink, did you have one that happened in maybe Super Bowl 32?
Well,
or is there a different one?
No, yeah, well, I mean, I did single-handedly win Super Bowl 32. Let me tell you the story, because it's absolutely...
Hey, put them up, 500.
It is,
tell us about the helicopter plane.
Absolutely incredible. Okay, so it's we drive down. It's a 17-17 ball game. We're on the 12-yard line. It's third down and six. You know, when Elway comes back into the huddle, right, with the play. And you know how Elway, he was all, like, walking into the huddle like this, right, because he's all knock-kneed. So he calls the play. He calls two jet, all go, Z shallow cross, right? So we're like, two jet, all okay, we're ready for go. So he gets in there, blue 80, blue 80, said Hutt, and he backs out of the thing, right? And all of a sudden he scrambles to the right, and he takes off. He gets hit by three Green Bay Packers. You guys remember it, right? Does the helicopter spin? Everybody remember that? It was awesome. So we're all running up there because he's 38 years old. He's sacrificing his body, and we're pulling him up. And about that time, you know, the official's going first down. And at that time, I knew that I had single-handedly won the Super Bowl, because here's what happened. If I don't miss my block, Elway is never forced out of the pocket. He never scrambles. That inspired us to victory. And by the way, Elway sucked in that game. He was awful. He was awful.
Good thing you
had TD. Yeah, so I essentially single-handedly won Super Bowl 32. You guys are welcome.
Give him a round of applause.
Great job, Mark.
Hey, before we go, though, now tell them, Stink, O-line rooms, we got fine boards.
Yeah.
How much was that dance right there you just did? $1,200?
That thing was a grand at least.
Yeah, $1,000. And it's so high, you say, do you want to settle? Because that's how you know it's going to be a high dollar amount.
Corey has a question from Table 25 that I'm going to open up to all you guys as well. And maybe even you too, Suze. Ryan, what is the biggest baller experience you've had? Now, Stink was actually on the show Ballers, but I think they mean, hey, you're in the NFL, I'm a baller.
Man, going to the ESPYs was pretty cool. My wife and I, we sat next to Lolo Jones at the time. I didn't know, you know, so we're just around, and I got to meet, you know, Shaquille O'Neal and all. That was pretty baller, and the red carpet was thick, like 6 inches, you know.
It's a good red carpet out there.
It's a great red carpet.
It's been a bunch.
Yeah, so I'd say the ESPYs for sure.
Carl, did you have one of those, hey, I'm Carl Mecklenburg, I'm in the NFL, when you're here? No, you didn't
see the gentle giant.
No, okay. Stink, I know you've had a few, and you're on the show Ballers.
I was just a big, fat offensive lineman. I didn't get invited anywhere. Yeah, I didn't do anything.
You had it all post-playing career.
Well, yeah, I mean, post-playing career, I got to do movies, and I've been a recurring role on Detective Rock Hoover on the Guiding Light, excuse me. Rock Hoover on the Guiding Light. 72 years that show was on air, both on radio and TV. 2 years took me to knock
radio
it off.
Radio, too?
Tells you about my acting career. It took me 2 years to get that show canceled. I was on Ballers for 6 years.
Canceled?
Canceled that, yeah. So I got that canceled. I've had some pretty cool opportunities.
I did think of one. I hosted a ski race in Aspen for years. That was a blast.
Yeah.
A lot of neat people. That was probably my most baller.
All right, that counts. And then Suze, you've been a rock chick your whole life too. So.
Well, yeah, I've got some good, you know, there's rock moments, but mine was really John Elway was, you know, such my idol growing up. And so when the Crush won the AFL championship out in Las Vegas, I got to interview John, and that was the first time I'd interviewed John. And I thought I had died and gone to heaven. I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm interviewing John Elway. And then later I hosted a show and things like that. But that first moment where you have that iconic person that you're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm actually like talking to this. And it was, you know, it was the AFL champion, it was the Arena League championship with the Colorado Crush. So that was pretty cool. That was my moment.
That is cool. All right, final one we have, because we got to get going. Got plenty more program to do. This comes from Matthew at Table 35, but I'll ask all you guys, and Susie, you can chime in as well. Who was your favorite teammate that you ever played with?
Oh
Wow, I had a lot of great teammates that I played with and that I absolutely loved, all the way back to my Washington days. A ton of guys out there as a member of the Hogs that really, you know, taught me how to play and taught me how to cut my teeth in the league. But probably my favorite teammate ever was Dave Diaz-Infante.
Doc.
Doc. And the reason was is we were so tight. And this is one of the things I love about football in general. We affectionately called Doc the stunt guard because Doc would practice for me all week, and then I would play on Sundays. And so we call him the stunt guard. And you would think that that would create a level of animosity. And we couldn't be closer. We had a great relationship. We studied together. We prepped together. He got me ready to play every Sunday. And you learn so much about people and people's hearts and what they're willing to do by the way they treat others and how they sacrifice for one another. And that's what makes great teams. The teams, to me, that I had that I was blessed to be a part of that were championship quality teams all had this attitude of servants and had this attitude of what can I do to make my team better? Not so much for me to, you know, to get the shine, but for everybody else to have that success. And so Doc was that guy for me.
Mac? You guys did a radio show together, didn't you?
Yeah, we did. We did a radio show together.
760.
We're still connected. He's coaching with the Chargers right now. So he's one of my go-to sources. If you ever hear me talk Charger stuff, you know, you probably know where I got it from.
Mac, do you have a favorite teammate?
Yeah, Dennis Smith. Dennis Smith was already a really good player when I got to the league, and he just watching his preparation, his approach to the game, I think inspired me. And through the years, you know, our families have gotten really close. We've, you know, done Thanksgivings together and trips together and all kinds of stuff. Dennis is my man.
Now, Ryan, Vaughn's parents are sitting over there, but they won't tell him if you don't say Vaughn.
I will tell you, Vaughn's the only man that bought me underwear. He's the only other man that bought me underwear.
That's pretty
unique. I had some holy underwear. He said, dawg, you can't go out like that, man. I can't let you go home. So he gave me, he probably got $500 from some company or something. So so Vaughn was a good teammate. It's hard not to say Peyton, but DeMarcus Ware was unbelievable. We were going against Pittsburgh the first time, and he said, hey, Ryan, man, nobody knows this, but the way to beat James Harrison when he throws that rip move in, you know, clamp your elbow, you know, to your side. So I go into the game. I'm like, well, I'm going to try it, you know, say, sure. Let's see, dog, you know. So we went in and bop, and in the play, and sometimes you guys know you can take somebody's soul in a play. And in a play, James Harrison goes, oh, man, my day's done. And he didn't try that rip move the rest of the game. And I was like, hey, DeMarcus, man, that really worked. Thank you so much. That was awesome, you know. So DeMarcus Ware was just, he did so much more than excel on the field. And it's part of the reason why we won a championship.
Yeah, something tells me if you'd ask Vaughn's parents, they'd tell you that DeMarcus Ware might be very high, if not the number one on the top of Vaughn's list. And Suze, I'll ask you, you've worked in radio and TV here for years. You and I have worked together a lot, but if you don't say my name, I won't be offended. Who's your your favorite?
Well, my favorite is Dave Logan. I mean, yeah. That's a guy I've worked with in many different stints throughout radio, and we can pick it up wherever we left off, and it's like it's one of those things, and he is just the ultimate professional. Any of you guys that have, you know, talked with him and worked with him, he's just one of those guys, and obviously has the pedigree to back it up as an athlete, and is just an incredible broadcaster.
All right, well, I'll take solace knowing that I'm second. You're my favorite realtor in town.
Oh, thank you.
She sold me my house. Mark Schlereth, Super Bowl champ 3 times, future Hall of Famer, Ring of Famer, Carl Mecklenburg, Super Bowl champ, Ryan Harris,
woo!
And, of course, the great Suze Worgen. Thanks, guys. I'm Brandon Kristol. We'll see you next time.
That was fun. Great questions, you guys. That was fantastic. Coming out to our Vaughn's Vision event tonight. And by the way, if you do walk around, we do ask that you have your masks on. You can have them off at your table. We will not be like the NFL, who just announced they have fined 3 NFL head coaches, Pete Carroll, Kyle Shanahan, and Vic Fangio, $100,000 for not wearing their masks in their games this weekend. So we won't be that bad, promise. All right, just want to give you a reminder. All right, once again, we want to thank you here for coming here tonight. And in 2018, just to give you a little bit of background about Vaughn's Vision, they launched their now signature Vaughn's Vision Center program. These are mobile kiosks that are really cool. They're installed within the Metro Denver Boys and Girls Clubs, and they house frames, accessories, and the equipment needed to provide kids with the gift of sight. That is what we are doing here tonight. That's what you're all contributing to, and we greatly appreciate that. This fall, Vaughn's Vision is excited to open up its fourth overall Vision Center and the third here in Denver through a partnership with Schomp Automotive and Subaru. Funded through the Subaru Loves to Care program, this Vision Center will serve hundreds of local students in the years to come. These kiosks are so cool. So at this time, I would like to invite up James Kurtenbach from Schomp Automotive to help Vaughn's Vision unveil the newest Vaughn's Vision Center. James, come on up.
Thought we were going to do some magic tricks here, James. I'm Mark Osborne. This is James Kurtenbach. We're from Schomp Automotive. We had some tough acts to follow there.
We did. Yeah. We paid Mark Schlereth, and we're still talking.
We did.
Yeah.
I thought back. I did win the pitch, hit, and throw when I was 12. I was pretty proud of that. I know that doesn't compete with the guys up here, but anyways, seriously, probably our best sports experience is that we're on Vaughn's team. And we're proud to be on Vaughn's team. It's really amazing to see his compassion, his authenticity for his care for the kids. And James is going to talk about Vaughn's vision and how it's such a good match for Schomp Automotive.
Thanks, Mark. There's a few people here that know Aaron Wallace, the owner of Schomp Automotive. So I'm going to get vulnerable for a second here and tell you why we're on the stage. So Aaron Wallace came, well, actually didn't even come to me. He sent me an email. And he goes, I want you to talk to Jeff at Vaughn's Vision. And so I took a look at the deck that they had. It's about this event. It's about this special thing right here. And I ended up pitching this idea to Aaron Wallace. And the whole time I didn't know he was actually on the board for the foundation. So marketer of the year right here. That's great. But no, we're super happy to be a part of this. It fits really well with the Schomp Giving platform. A couple years ago, we came to the realization we were in need of really clarifying how we gave in our community. And an important thing that we wanted to keep Lisa Schomp's legacy with and Aaron's passion about is kids' mental wellness and physical wellness. So when I didn't have to pitch this to Aaron Wallace, I was talking about how this was such a fantastic fit. And we couldn't be more proud to be supporting it. And we thank all of you for being here tonight and being a part of it. Thank you.
All right, let's do the unveiling of the kiosk. 1, 2, 3, let's see it. There we go. Everybody say, ooh. Right, very nice. And so this will go into a Boys and Girls Club this fall when they get them back opened up. So guys, thank you so much. Thank you to Schomp Automotive and Subaru. The other presenting sponsor we have here this evening is Hero Practice Services. They are instrumental in making this outreach happen as well. Hero serves as the signature lens partner of Vaughn's Vision for all of the foundation outreach programs. Vaughn's Vision would not be possible without the support of Hero. So at this time, I would like to bring up Josh Gwynn to come say a few words. Josh? Oh, good. You went casual as well. Great job with the shoes. I like that.
SMJ, Susie. Guys, so welcome. And first and foremost, I want to thank Vaughn himself for all the support that he gives the foundation. Obviously, none of this is possible without him. When I first talked to Vaughn the first time about how this all come together, the stories he would always say is he started and he just wanted to help one kid. And he said if we could just help one kid, he'd really feel like he had done something. You know, to date, we've helped thousands of children around the Denver metro, also some in Texas and other places. And it's become something more than I think any of us really expected that it could. For us at Hero, and before I go, I'm going to give a shout out to these three tables right here. These folks at tables 1, 2, and 9 are some of the most special people I've ever seen. So hands raised for you guys. Incredible, incredible work. We've got a couple of our optometrists here. These are the folks who actually do the eye exams. These are the people who cut the lenses. They're the ones who give their time, their effort, and spend their money to make sure that these kids get everything they need every time they come in. So really want to give them all the appreciation. Hero's got almost 1,000 total teammates, about 14 locations up and down the Front Range. And we're very proud to be sponsors and be able to bring in Vaughn's Locker program. So now every single child who walks into a Hero adventure or Academy Kids Vision Center has the opportunity to get glasses no matter if they can pay or not. So we know 90% of children have some form of insurance, but 10% of kids in this world do not have insurance. And now if they come see us through Vaughn's Vision, we'll be able to see every single one of them at no charge. That's what you guys are working towards today. That's why we ask you, open up your hearts, open up your wallets. Let's make sure that these kids get what they need. There's never been a more important time than right now. What we've seen at Hero is over 180,000 children miss their appointments during the shutdown of COVID-19. That's 180,000 kids that we serve. We now know that kids in low-income neighborhoods across the country, let alone in our backyard, are suffering. They're on screens more than they ever have been. Their eyes are more taxed than ever before. And now's the time that we can help as many as possible. The partnership that Hero's created with Vaughn allows those kids to have a continuum of care. So if they come in to a Vaughn's event, if they come in and they see this kiosk at one of the Boys and Girls Clubs, we'll house their electronic medical records inside of Hero, inside of Adventure, and they can now come back to us for any needed care that they need, and the cycle continues. These kids will be taken care of for the rest of their lives through what you guys are creating tonight. So thank you guys. Raise your glass. Raise your hands, make sure that you're bidding on these items coming up, and let's have an incredible, incredible rest of the evening. Thank you guys for everything that you do. We really appreciate y'all.
Very good. Thank you, Josh, so much from Hero Practice Services. All right, we also want to acknowledge two more sponsors that we have in the room here with us this evening who support the foundation with their incredible services. Etnia Barcelona, provides the foundation with fashion-forward frames that give our program beneficiaries the confidence to wear glasses with pride. Sometimes that's part of the problem with the kiddos is they don't want to wear those glasses, but if they've got some nice frames, that'll give them a little more motivation. Also, Icon Eye Care, a new foundation sponsor, supports these programs by providing the doctors to staff the Vision Center at regular exam days, making this outreach possible. So big hand for Icon Eye Care and Etnia Barcelona. Thank you so much for your support as well. All right, at this time, let's turn our attention again to the screen. He has accomplished much in his career, including MVP of Super Bowl 50. He, of course, is the MVP of Vaughn's Vision, and Vaughn Miller joins us live virtually tonight. Hello, Vaughn.
Howdy, guys. It's a little bit different this year. Due to my injury that I suffered about 10 days ago, I wasn't able to make it, but I want to thank everyone again for being here tonight and helping me make my philanthropic dream a reality. Many of you were here last year when we first unveiled our Vaughn's Locker program with Hero Practice Services. From the money we raised on this night last year, we were able to initiate 13 lockers with Hero Practice Services. Due to COVID-19, there has really been a delay in getting these lockers launched, but we have all locations selected and lockers ready to go once we're able to safely install them. As we look to the rest of 2020 and into 2021, we plan to continue and develop and innovate our outreach. We just want to keep doing more. After we get through this quarantine period or whatever this period is that we're going through as a nation, we just want to keep doing more and more and, just keep developing and keep creating. Our continued partnership with Hero Practice Services is critical to this development, along with our new partnership with Shomp Automotive and Subaru. I am so excited that all of you are able to view our newest Vaughn's Vision Center with Shomp Automotive and Subaru. With this Vision Center, we will be able to serve 200 children over the next few months, which is crazy. If you think about where we started at, with just, one or two kids to all the wonderful stuff that we're doing now. There's a huge gap in our community for vision care and education. And now with COVID-19, the gap is even wider. It's crazy. We can't do any of this stuff without you. And I want to thank you again for being here tonight and supporting Vaughn's Vision. This event has always been, wonderful, for Vaughn's Vision and for me. I love coming out and doing this stuff with you guys. And, it's been a crazy year. But this is the new normal, and we just gotta find a way to keep pushing as a nation and find a way to keep doing our thing. Thank you guys. I appreciate you guys.
All right, Vaughn, thank you. Appreciate you. Love all your Longhorn stuff you got going on there in the back.
Yeah, I'm just in the living room. I got you know, this stuff going on. I can't really go anywhere. I got to keep my foot elevated, but I'm here.
And you're watching Monday Night Football. I can see the football screen on your TV or in your window there.
Emmanuel, gotcha. Emmanuel just got a first down or something.
All right, Vaughn. Well, there's lots of people here tonight. It extends out into the tarmac, and the cars are amazing. The jets are amazing. We wish you were here. We've got a stand-up with the background, and you're next to it from the roundup, so people can go take your picture. I know that you wish you were here so you could get pictures with everybody, because I know you love doing that.
Yeah, that's one of the great parts of these events every night. But next year, we always got next year, so it'll be good.
That's right. And everybody's got a football with your name on it, so we appreciate that. And we're going to do heads and tails here in a little bit and get a helmet with your name on that as well. So thanks, and we'll see you soon. Heal
right,
quickly.
I appreciate you guys.
All right, Thank Vaughn you. Miller, ladies Thank and gentlemen. All right. Sorry I had to call him out for watching Monday Night Football there, but I could see it in his window. All right, so now you heard Vaughn mention 13 lockers they were able to do with the money that was raised from last year. Last year's event was phenomenal. Part of the reason is because we have an amazing auctioneer that does a great job with all of our live auction items and our paddle raise, and I would like to bring him up at this time. Matt Rogers, he was a finalist on American Idol several years ago. He has also served as host of Discovery Channel's Gold Rush and The Deadliest Catch. Let's hear it from Matt Rogers.
Thank you.
There he is.
Hello. Susie, you are fantastic.
Thank
you. Can we hear it for Susie again? She's just doing a phenomenal job.
Thank you.
How's everybody doing tonight? There's like 30. Where are the happy people at? Over here? There we go. My name's Matt Rogers. Who has been to this event before in the last 2 years? Not many. Okay, hold on. For real. Like, this is participation time. Who has never been to this event or has not been in the last 2 years? Please raise your hand. I'm looking in the back, too. Oh, snap. This is like 70% newbies. This is going to be fantastic. I'm so happy to be here tonight. I got faith, baby. I got faith that we're going to break through everything that everyone says, how bad everything is, and it's a terrible time to fundraise, and then Vaughn gets injured, and it's just like we're going to break through that tonight because we are here for a way, way bigger cause. As you guys are enjoying your fun and your great meal, you're going to have a fantastic dessert for those of you who don't have it yet. The food is phenomenal. But most importantly, like we said, we are here to raise money to support the outreach programs for Vaughn's Vision. Can I get an amen? All right. Maybe come up and church up in here, baby. I'll do it. I ain't scared. So here's some facts that all y'all need to know, especially for the newbies. This is very, very important and why you're here. Across the entire district, the Denver Public Schools has more than 27,000 low-income students who need some level of vision correction. Vaughn's Vision continues working to reduce that number, but new children enter the school system every year that desperately need your help. And through the partnership and organizations like Hero Practice Services, Vaughn's Vision is able to permanently change lives of children across your great state. So before we get the night kicked off, everybody in the back, I was sitting in the back earlier, and I know that the bar is back there and there's some chatter, but we really need you and we really want you to feel included. And this video is why you're here and the most important part of the night. So please, everybody, direct your attention to the video screen. Thank you.
Hero is a pediatric dental, vision, and orthodontic-focused organization. We support practices across the country, and we are the number one Medicaid provider for children in Colorado.
We work with Vaughn's Vision in a couple different ways. We furnish eye exams and glasses for people in need. We work through the Boys and Girls Club. We also work through the Vaughn's Locker program. And so there's different events that connect us in the community that we can reach to people normally that we wouldn't be able to. I would say what most people and children want out of life is the opportunity to succeed. The thing that they really don't have a say in is, you know, they're young. They don't know what's normal.
As a child, I didn't know until third grade that I needed glasses. And I didn't know when they told me I needed glasses that I needed glasses. And what I mean by that is you only have the perception that you're born with. And if you perceive the world to be one way through your eyes, then that's just the way the world is until you're shown differently.
Most don't realize because children really don't know what normal is. And so if they're, you know, just putting up with this, it might be what they're so used to that it's hard for them to ask for help. And that's where we come in, you know, really giving them the examination and the tools to help succeed.
We want to prevent that early. We want to give kids every opportunity to see clearly, see correctly, understand their full potential, and live their lives to the top of their ability. An organization like Vaughn's Vision specifically is targeting things that, you know, sometimes can be seen as social stigmas. Sometimes kids are bullied or you know, looked on differently because they wear eye care, and Vaughn makes it cool. Vaughn puts on that eyewear and he makes it cool. And a chance to meet, you know, one of the greatest linebackers in the history of the NFL is enough to bring kids in and sometimes even motivate their parents to come in and do what's right so that we can get this taken care of. So any community partners that can really lock in with us and build a coalition to do everything we can to create, you know, the best we can for our kids, it's going to create the future. And the future can be incredibly bright or not. It's going to be based on how much we dig in, we come together, and we build something for these kids now. There is a massive gap in care in our nation and in our state, and children fall through the cracks all the time. If those children don't get the help that they need and nobody reaches out to give them the services, then they're just going to continue to fall further and further behind.
It's important for community partners like Vaughn's Vision to be involved because we really can't let these kids down. We want access of care, awareness out there, and education so we can build them up so they can succeed, not only in school, but in life.
Awesome. So far, they've accomplished a lot, but obviously there's much more that needs to be done. Every year, 5,000 new first graders start school without ever seeing an eye doctor. So you can imagine how far they already are as they produce later in life. They struggle in the first and the second grade because, like the gentleman said, they don't even know what's normal and what's normal to you and me. It costs $500 to provide a full exam, screening, high-end frames, and prescription lenses to one child. So tonight, our goal is we want to raise enough money to provide services and glasses for 200 children. If y'all could do the math there, that's about $100,000. So again, one thing I've learned through working with Vaughn and his team is Vaughn has heart and he stands behind his cause. And even though he can't be here tonight, normally we would have teammates up here, sell jerseys, Vaughn would be here and it would be phenomenal. But I could promise you, man, it's one thing that I've learned is he will make it up to you if we can really stand up and hold the mantle for him tonight. We need you. The very fact that you're in this room is evidence that we need you. It's like my mom always used to say, I'm going to reference my mama. I flew in here from Nashville, Tennessee, because I wanted to be here with you guys. Like, I want to be in the room with you. And my mom always used to tell me that your rewards in life are determined by the problems that you can solve. And she said, what you make happen for somebody else, God will always make what will happen for you. So tonight, we need you. We're going to start with our fund to need, and this is where we start at a level, and we work down from there, and we're looking for heroes. So I would just encourage you, please, 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 as you're blessed, be a blessing to somebody else, and instead of looking for the hero, please you decide to be the hero tonight. Vaughn, like I said, has heart, and he backs up what he says, so he's going to kick the night off with $58,000 towards his vision, and that is awesome. But it's hopefully it'll inspire you to join him. And he's not just a guy that says, oh, let's get all these people in the room and raise as much money as you can. Like, he backs it up. So please, we're going to start at our $10,000 level. How great would it be if we can get a handful of people? And again, I know there's people from different financial backgrounds, so please give what you can. If you're able to give $10,000, raise your bidder paddle, and I promise you this room will absolutely explode. Anybody at $10,000, raise your bidder paddle at me. Someone scream in the back. If I don't see him, anyone at $10,000, I don't want to miss anybody. $10,000, Is there one person that can give 10,000 going once? Anybody at 10,000 going twice? Okay, now how about $5,000? Anybody at 5,000? Bitter Paddles going up at $5,000, and I'll read off the number, and everybody will cheer. Anybody at $5,000? Yell at me for $5,000. Yell or point at me for $5,000. Anybody at 5,000? Again, we need you guys tonight, and I promise you in the future, we will make up. Can we give a round of applause for 203? 203 at $5,000. Yes, someone's whistling at me. Let's get another one. One more at $5,000. Anybody at 5,000, we can kick this night off with the 10 that we wanted. Anybody, 5,000 going once? Please, 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 anyone's able to give 5,000 one more time. Last call. Thank you so much. You can see it means a lot. Can we give a round of applause right here for 203 for $5,000? How about $2,500? It would be so awesome if we get four people at $2,500. Yes, bitter paddles up. Keep your bitter paddles up until I read your number. And hey, if you don't have your paddle in the air, please put your hands together. This is our $2,500 level to 047. 047. Wave that bitter paddle at me, please. 108. 108. Bitter paddle right here. Can you raise that? I need to call the number off for our recorders. Thank you so much. 085. 085. Was there someone else in the back that I missed? I got 047. That's one donation for $2,500 for 047. That's three total. Can we get one more at $2,500 if you're able to do it? Oh, snap. There she is. 173. 173. How is no one clapping for you right now? This is great. We're already off to a great start. That's 15,000 plus Vaughn's 58. Y'all know I told you before I'm an ex-football player, 1.96 GPA. What's the math on that one? 58 plus 15 is 73K. Here we go. This is where all the smart people sit. All right, now we're going to $1,000. Can we lean on 10 people? 10 people to give $1,000, and I promise you this place will explode. And if you're down with it, I'll give chest bumps, okay? But if you don't, I won't make anyone uncomfortable. Raise your bitter paddles. Yes, here's one right here. Until I call your number off. Hands together if you don't have your bitter paddles in the air, and I'll start reading it off. 001, 001, 172, 172. That's two people. Is there anybody else? Can we get three more? Three more at $1,000. Anybody would give $1,000? $1,000. Bitter paddles up. Thank you so much. 112. 112. And in the back, 002. 002. That's four. You know what? Can I just give you a little bit right here? Just a little. Just a, booyah. There we go. That's 115. 115 at 1,000. Anybody else? 1,000 going once. Yell at me in case I miss them. $1,000 going twice. Last call. Give a round of applause for everyone that just gave $1,000. And now is our $500 level. Please, please, please. Bitter paddles going up everywhere at $500. Please, bitter paddles up at $500. We need you now more than ever. As you can see, we need you more than ever. $500. Please raise it in the air, and I will call your number off at $500. Put your hands together for 021. 021. Let's go, baby. Let's clap a little bit more now. 122. 122. 017. 017. 014. 014. 040. 040. Anybody else? Keep the applause going. Bitter paddles up. Thank you. 135. 135. Again, this is $500. That felt like somewhere around $3,000. Anyone else able to give? Yes, 014. 014 at 500. Anybody else at $500? I don't want to miss anybody. 500 going once. 500 going twice. Can we give a round of applause for everyone that just gave $500? And this will be our last level right here, and then we're going to get into the live auction, and we are going to have a blast. I'll talk about that in a minute. But now, this is our $250 level. Could we get everybody in the room to raise your paddles at $250? Come on. Let's get at least. We can get at least 10, 15 people. Keep your hands together or your bitter paddles up until I call. We got some numbers going up here. Put your hands together for 110, 110-153-135-034-035-025-030-025-030-120. Thank you, 121-070-070-053-053-066. Keep the applause going for 066-136-136. Anybody else at 250? Yes, 080-080. Thank you so much. And do we get 136? Yes, so much. Anybody else? $250 going once. Do it. Do it. Do it. 250. There it is. There it is. 071. 071. Anybody else? 250. Once. Twice. Last call. Give a round of applause for everyone that just gave $250. Okay, that was the fun to need. Are we having a good time yet? Yes? All right. So before we kick it off, are we good with the live? We are? Oh my God, he's here. He's so tall and he's got such nice legs and he kicks such long field goals and he's your man. Oh, we're not going there yet. So then we're gonna go to the Grammy artist first. Oh, we're going straight to live. Well, then there you go, Austin. You look gorgeous tonight. How about a round of applause for Austin? Just got voted most sexiest man of Rancho Cucamonga, California in the house. Austin and his team does a great job for tonight. Who wants some live auction items? Anybody? You guys aren't selling me here. Here we go. I need everybody to raise your bidder paddles. Everybody. Even if you're on a tight budget and you don't plan on bidding, don't worry. I'm not going to dupe you. I need everybody in the whole airport hangar to raise your bidder paddles for two reasons. One, like this table over here. Thank you so much. I'm not going to play a trick. For one, we want you to know this is how you bid. And let's have some fun. Yell at me. Scream at me. Typically, I'll go in the audience, call nicknames, do high fives. Tonight might be a little bit different because I want to respect everybody's space and privacy. But everyone bidder paddles up because also we want our photography team and video team to take some awesome pictures. And if you don't have your bidder paddle up, people are going to know you went to Vaughn's event and you weren't even bidding nothing. It's going to look really embarrassing. So everyone up. Everyone up. Okay, thank you so much. That is how you bid. And that is how it's going to go down tonight. Are there any Broncos fans in the house? Okay. All right, good. What we're going to do is Vaughn wants to give you his suite for a game this year. So two people are going to watch their favorite team like never before, and you are going to watch it from Vaughn's personal suite. So you're in Vaughn's suite with all the people, most likely his family, some of his close friends. I mean, is there a better seat in the house than Vaughn's seat? You're going to get two tickets, and you're going to use it for a home game in the 2021 season. Right up there, as you can see, everything is right there, but there's no catches to it. Vaughn's suite, two people. The value of this is $3,500. I'll start it super low. I'll start it at a grand. How about $1,000? Who wants to go to a Broncos game this year? $1,000. Yes, $1,000 over here. Okay, here's how fundraisers work. If there's about 200 people here tonight, and this beautiful young lady raises her hand at $1,000, what should the rest of the people be doing? Yes! I know, right? Seriously, $1,000 over here. Let's hear it for her at $1,000. She's got it at $1,000. What do you go, $1,500? $1,000 now, $1,500. $1,500 over here up front. You got about three claps. You got about three claps. $1,500. $1,500 over here now, $1,750. $1,500, what do you give, $1,750? Yes, $1,750 over here. Dude. You kind of look like Brandon McManus with, like, the beard. It's a good-looking dude right there. If I looked like you, I would have never got voted off American Idol. Governor Gorgeous is in the house at $1,750. $1,750, now $2,000. Oh, snap, she's back. $2,000. She's got $2,000. What do you give? $2,250. $2,000, now $2,250. Vaughn's suite, Vaughn's family, Vaughn's view, Vaughn's vision. If for some reason we raise more than it's worth, which is $3,500, who really wins here? The kids, baby. The kids. 1.96 is kicking in. Where were we at? 2,000? No, we're at 2,750. Is that right? Help me out, DJ Zanity. 2,750? We're at 2,750? 2,750 right back here. Who's taking him down? The kid. The youngin'. Who is this? I must know who you are. You look like a young Leo DiCaprio. Give it up for the Wolf of Wall Street right here. We got the Wolf at $27.50. Who wants to take down the kid and go $3,000? Will she come back? Everyone's looking. Everyone's nervous. The Wolf might be going to any game this year for $27.50 unless someone goes $3,000 going once. Oh, no. $3,000 going twice. Oh, snap. When Big Papa speaks, you listen. Yes, sir. Straight from the horse's mouth. I will let you say that. Tell him.
There's a real possibility that Vaughn may be in the suite with us.
There's a real possibility that Vaughn may be in the suite with us. $3,000 right here. $3,000. She did it at $3,000. $3,000. What do you give? $3,250. $3,000 now. $3,250. If not, she's getting it. It's her. It's Vaughn. It's not. It is the Wolf. $3,250. You are making the white tent hot tonight, baby. You guys are where it's at. $3,250 now. $35. $3,250. What do you give? $35. $3,250 now. $35. No pressure. Vaughn's family sitting right in front of you, and they're probably wondering. Just gonna say. No pressure. $3,500. The Wolf's got it at $3,250. I got to move on unless you go an extra $250. What is it? That's face value for the kids. Everyone wins. You go. See, Vaughn, yes! $3,500. $35, now $3,750 to the Wolf. $35, now $37. Oh, snap. He did it. Who is this kid? I must know who you are. Dude, let me get your Fortnite code after this, and we'll freaking battle 1v1 tonight. Let's go. $37.50, he ain't messing around. $37.50 now four. She said she's out. I think you got it. I think you did it. $37.50 going once. $37.50 now four, going twice. Oh! Oh, I know who you are. What was the nickname? That is Juicy Jen. Juicy Jen at $4,000. All right, Wolf, let me tell you this, and I do got to move on because I feel like I'm running a little over, but it's important. Juicy Jen is the stinking boss around here, okay? I don't know if y'all know this, but Juicy Jen, she will not be outbid. I cannot remember over the last 3 years the time anyone has outbid Juicy Jen. So I'm telling you, you will have notoriety, and you will be a boss if you go $42.50. It's only an extra $250, and you have bragging rights, and he did it! $42.50! $42.50! Oh, snap! $42.50. Will JJ go 45? If not, the Wolf is getting it at $42.50, going once. $42.50, going twice. Last call! You did it! You outbid Juicy Jen! Sold to 047! 047 at $42.50. I promised myself I wouldn't yell tonight. Can we give a round of applause for everyone that just made that fun? This just in. Bidder number, I feel like it was over here. Bidder number 085. Where is 085 or 85? Bidder paddle 85. I thought, yeah, it was right there. Here we go. Thank you so much. All right, moving on. Any golfers in the house? One right here? Well, this should go well. Here we go. Who wants to go to Pebble Beach? Pebble Beach Golf Experience. This is the Monterey Peninsula, the world-renowned golf destination, offering the most dramatic settings of golf anywhere. If you're a golfer, you know what is going down at Pebble Beach. It is an iconic stop for the PGA Tour. You are going to get a three-night stay in a golf course view room at the Hyatt Regency in Monterey. You are going to get golf for two, including the golf cart, at the Links at Spanish Bay in Pebble Beach. And you're also going to get a round for two at Del Monte Golf Course in Pebble Beach. And you're going to get round-trip airfare, so they're going to take care of your plane flight, your hotel, and your golf. The value of this package is just under $6,000. I'll start it super low. I'll start at $2,500. Who wants to go to Pebble? This is where you team up with your wife, your husband, your partner, your buddy, business partner, company. I mean, this is a no-brainer right here. The value is just under $6,000. I'll start at $2,500. Who wants that $2,500? $2,500 now three. $3,000 over here now 35. 3,000 out, 35. 35 over here. Anyone at 3,500? 30. Yes, 3,500 in the back. How's no one cheering for it? 3,500. 3,500 now, 3,750. 35 now, 3,750. I'll only go short, $250 increments. Super steal. 3,500 now, 3,750. 35, what do you give? 3,750. 3,500 now, 3,750. Really? I'm going to close it out at 3,500? Yes, 3,750. How's no one clapping for you? 3,750 now, four. 3,750, what do you give for? In a surprise shocker tonight, $4,000. The back of the tent is on fire tonight. 4,000 back there. We still? 4,000? 4,000 over here, what do you give? 4,250. 4,000 now, 4,250. 4,000, what do you give? 4,250. If not, she's getting it at $4,000. Going once. $4,000. Going twice. 4,250, yes! 40. Oh, snap, I just noticed something. Are you number 58? That's pretty tight, bro. Number 58 is getting that. No one's catching the irony there. Von Miller's number 58. All right, here we go. 58, you got a 20, what was that? 4,250. 42 now, 45. 42, yes, at 45. 45 now, 48. 45 now, 48. 45, what do you get, 48? If you go 48, that's an extra $300, well worth it. Just under $6,000 value. Von's Vision, 48. Pebble Beach, Spanish Bay, 48. 4,800, he did it! Here's what we'll do, because I want to honor your time and everyone's time. I am allowed for this one package to double it at $4,800. That means you would go an extra $300. We'll stop it. You'll win at 48. You'll win at 48. And the foundation will win at $9,600 total. If you raise your bidder paddle, we'll stop it. She did it! Sold, sold to 044, 044, and 058, 058. Guys, can we get a round of applause for everybody that just gave? DJ Zanity, you know what we got to do? Every time after we sell something, you just got to play like a little 10-minute or a 10-second. Can we do that? Set it up if you can. I don't know. No pressure. Moving on, item number three, and we got some fantastic ones for you tonight. This is four nights in a Hawaiian paradise. You're going to enjoy four nights at a luxury stay at the Fairmont Kailani Maui, resting gracefully on Polo Beach. It is ideal for snorkeling and discovering tropical fish and turtles as you swim near the Wailea Point Reef. The resort is located close to Wailea's championship golf course, and you are going to have a spectacular ocean view. As you can see from the screen, here's what you're going to get. You are going to get four nights in a suite at the Fairmont Kailani Maui, one of the top 500 hotels in the world. You're going to get daily breakfast every day for two. You are going to get round trip for two from basically anywhere, probably Denver to Maui. So there you go. Four nights, top 500 hotels in the world, breakfast every day, round trip. Who wants to go to Hawaii? The value of this package is just over $9,000, about $9,100. I'll start it super low. I'll start at $3,000. $3,000. Bitter paddle's going up at $3,000. That's like a 70% discount. $3,000. Yes, $3,000 over here now, four. $4,000 now, four. $4,000, yes, now, five. $5,000 over here. What do you get? $5,000. $5,000, yes. I'll go slow now. $5,500. Anybody at $5,500? $5,500. Anybody at $5,500? If not, I'll close it out at $5,000 because I feel like I'm a little behind and we have a lot of items. I'll close it out at $5,000 if anyone goes to $5,500. $5,500. Yes, $5,500 back there. She's got a $5,500. Would he go six? $5,500 now, six. She's got a $5,500. Would he go six? You are getting a smoking deal. I think you got it. $5,500 now, six. Going once. $5,500 now, six. Going twice. Last call, Hawaii, $6,000. No brainer. Sold for $5,500 to 005. Oh, yeah. 005. Hit it up. You got some? Just give me a little freaky freaky for like 10 seconds. Oh, yeah. There you go. Turn it up. All right, item number four here. This is our Rock and Roll Legends guitar. So here's the deal. Typically, we would have the guitar right up here for you. I don't know all of the details, but because of everything that's going on, they're afraid to ship it, to have a bunch of people touch it, so they didn't want a bunch of people touching it and having the guitar sit here, and then you would take it home. So here's what it is. You can see it right here on the screen, okay? And here is who signed this guitar. This is super freaking cool. This is a classic Rock and Roll Legends guitar, And it is signed by Eddie Van Halen, Eric Clapton, Jimmy Page, Carlos Santana, Slash from Guns N' Roses, Neil Young, Edge, and Pete Townsend. So in the past, I've sold one that wasn't that cool for close to 10 grand. They say the value of this is 6,000. I'll start it super low. I'll start at 1,500 bucks, and it'll get shipped to you, of course. 1,500 over here now, too. 2,000 now, 25. 2,000, yes, 25 over here now, 3,000. 3,000, 2,500 over here. What do you give 3,000? 25, ooh, that was so close. That was so close back there. Oh, yeah, I'm talking to you guys. The disagreement at the table, she almost did it. And we're going to have some fun tonight. But don't worry, we got it at 2,500 over here. Someone could still take it at 3,000. 2,500. Yes, 3,000. How is no one clapping for you? So quiet, so mysterious, so under the radar. Can we give it up for the sniper over here at $3,000? No one sees you coming. $3,000. How about 3,500? 3,000 now, 35. If not, you're getting a deal. $3,000, 35 going once. 3,000 now, 35 going twice. Last call. Sold for $3,000 to 090. Do it. Are you guys together? Kiss her. Kiss her. She did it. Kiss her with the mask on. Order. Yeah, there you go. You go, boy. You did it. Slash is coming to your house in the form of a signature. Well done. Are we having fun yet? I really hope you guys aren't tired of me because we have like 12 items left. So here we go. This is the ultimate outdoorsman experience. After a year long of being cooped up inside or 6 months, you are going to unleash your inner outdoorsman and you are going to experience the great outdoors like never before. This hunting and fishing dual package will take you all the way to South Dakota to hunt pheasant and to the South Dakota Platte River to fly fish for rainbow trout. How cool is this? You are going to get 3 days and 4 nights of professionally guided pheasant hunting at the Thunderstick Lodge at Rooster Ridge. 4 people are going to go on a private hunt across 7,000 acres of private property. Also, fly fishing 1 day. Fly fishing for 2 of you at the North Fork of the South Platte River. I'm not sure if that's Platte or Platte, but it's bomb. Is it Platte? I should know that coming from the country, and that's why I am not smart, and you guys are. You're going to get also an extra 2 nights in a private cabin. All of the equipment and the tackle is included. So you just got to show up with an appetite for some good old fish and some good old pheasant. Any ladies going to bid on this one? Awesome. Here we go. We're going to start the value of this is, so the hunting is $8,000. The fishing is $3,100. So the value is just over $11,000. I'm going to start it low. I can't go any lower than $4,000. 4,000. Yes, 4,000. Now 5. 5 over here. Now 6,000. 5 over here. What do you give? 6,000. 6,000. Anybody at 6,000? I'll close it out at 5,000. If not, we're going to go 6,000. Anybody at 6,000? 5,000. Now 6. 5,000. Now 6. If not, I'm going to close it out at $5,000. Going once. 5,000. Going twice. Last call. Close it out right back there. Give a round of applause for $5,000. I did not see the number, but our volunteers will get to you. I'm going to move on. Thank you so much. You go, give a round of applause. Y'all are raising some money right now. And we are about halfway through. Who wants to raid Las Vegas? This is when you and 3 other couples are going to get together, and you are going to fly to Las Vegas, and you are going to enjoy a 5-star stay at the entertainment capital of the world for 3 days. You are going to enjoy the best of gambling, shopping, fine dining, and nightlife that the U.S. has to offer. Here is what this package includes. You're going to get 3 days and 2 nights for 8 people. So that's 4 couples. And you are going to choose where you want to stay. You could stay at the Mandarin Oriental, the Four Seasons, the Bellagio, the Aria, Mandalay Bay, the Hotel at Mandalay Bay, or the Signature at MGM Grand. And if that wasn't enough, y'all are going to do some fine dining at the best restaurant that Las Vegas has to offer. You are going to all dine for free. All you could eat and drink at Mastro's. So who knows where that night's going to go. So you're going to get dinner. You're going to get the suite. 4 couples. You're going to fly to Vegas. 3 days, 2 nights, Las Vegas. The value of this item with the package and everything is 20 grand. So I got to start. I'll give you a 75% discount. I'll start it at $5,000. Anybody at 5,000? Yes, 5,000 now six. Six now seven. Seven now 75. Seven, what do you give? 7,500. 7,000 now 75. 7,000, what do you give? 75. If not, I'm going to move on, and I'll close it out again at 7,000 going once. 7,000 now 75 going twice. Last call. Yes, right there. Round of applause. Give a round of applause for $7,000. Let me get a quick drink. Give a round of applause for everybody who's giving tonight. Next up is our Jackson Hole Wildlife Adventure. You're going to discover the beauty and the history of Jackson Hole, Wyoming, with an authentic western town surrounded by the breathtaking mountains and the rustic wilderness. You are going to enjoy a guided safari and fly fishing excursion all the way through Grand Teton National Park, the number one park in the U.S. for wildlife. I could tell you this. My family and I took the fifth wheel this summer, and we went all the way around America, and this was one place. And I promise you, I've never seen beauty like this before in my life. It is like driving through Jurassic Park with no rules, and you can do whatever you want. You're also going to get a half-day guided tour of the Grand Teton Wildlife Safari. You're also going to get breakfast, a one-day guided fly fishing on the Snake River, the South Fork, the New Fork, and the Green River. That is so cool. Fly fishing is phenomenal. Three-night stay in a guest room at the Rustic Inn Creekside Resort and Spa, the Lodge at Jackson Hole, and this accommodates two individuals. The value of this is $4,000. I'll start it super low. I'll start at $2,000. $2,000 for Jackson Hole is well worth it. $2,000. Yes, $2,000 now 25. $2,000, what do you give? 25. I'll go in little $500 increments. Yes, 2,500. Let's clap for 25, please. 25 now 3. 25 now 3,000. 2,500, what do you give? 3,000. 2,500, the bid's now 3,000. Anybody at 3,000? If not, you're going to get it at 2,500. Smoking deal. 2,500 going once. 2,500 now 3, going twice. Last call. Dude, you just got a smoking deal. Sold for 2,500. Show me that bidder paddle, please. That is 122. 122. How cool is this? This is one of my favorite auction items. We sold it last year for $15,000. What will it go for tonight? Vaughn needs you now more than ever. The kids need you now. Look what this is going to entail. You're going to head to Louisville for the 2021 Kentucky Derby with Vaughn Miller. For 144 years, the Kentucky Derby is one of the most historic and revered sporting events. They're going to give you two grandstand tickets with Vaughn to the 2021 Kentucky Derby on Saturday, May 1st, 2021 at the Kentucky Oaks. So this is really cool. I live in Tennessee. You cannot stay anywhere in Lexington, in Kentucky, everywhere around, and it's booked for like 7-8 years in advance. So you're going to get a three-night stay. You're going to check in on Thursday. You're going to check out on Sunday, and they're going to hook you up right in the heart of Louisville. You're going to get breakfast every single day. You're going to get a VIP pass allowing for faster and more secured access at Churchill Downs. You're also going to kick it with Vaughn on the rooftop terrace hospitality, including lunch buffet with beer, wine, sodas, meet and greet the celebrity jockeys. Put it this way, you're basically Vaughn's VIP guest. So when you watch it and you see all the celebrities on there, you're going to be one of them and you're going to be hanging out with them. Again, this sold last year for $15,000. What started low? I'll start at $5,000. How about $5,000? Yes, $5,000 now six. $5,000, what do you give? $6,000. $6,000, Kentucky Derby, Vaughn Miller. Two people. You cannot get this, of course. 6,000 back there. How's no one climb for you at 6,000? So awesome. 6,000. 6,000, what do you give? Seven. Six now seven. Six now seven. Six now seven. Again, yes. 7,000. Let's hear for $7,000 right here. 7,000 now eight. 7,000, what do you give? Eight. Still well worth it. It went for 15 last year. And seriously, I don't want to sound like a broken record, but as you guys could see, we need you tonight more than ever. Because we, oh, there he is, $8,000 in the back, $8,000 now nine, $8,000 would he give nine, $8,000 now nine, if not, I'll close it out at $8,000 now nine. This just in. $8,000, not to put any pressure on you, okay? He's got it at $8,000. I can do two. He wrote it down right now, and he said, he's actually going to let it go for a little bit cheaper because we want to raise the most money tonight. He's got it at 8. If you match him at 8,000, that'll be $16,000. I'll close it out right now. It's an extra $1,000 of where you were before. The hotel alone is worth it. You cannot get in. And you are VIP style with Vaughn. He's got it at 8. Will he go 8 right here to make it 16,000? Anybody, and you get a nickname, and the world will cheer. The children are counting on you. An extra $1,000. We got one at 8. Anybody else? He had it. He's going to let it go. 8,000 going once. He's got it at 8. Anyone match it at 8,000? Going twice. Last call. Sold in the back for 8,000. Throw me that bidder paddle, please. Show me that number one time. Thank you so much, 043. 043. Give them a round of applause, guys. That's $8,000. Thank you so much to everybody who's bidding. All right. That BMW X7 that you see walking up, that thing is fatty bobatty. That thing is awesome. How about this? Champ Automotive, as if they haven't done enough already, they believe in the cause, and they're such a good partner. They are going to give you that BMW for an entire year. So you get the BMW for a year. Where's Champ at? Champ's in the house. Champ right here? So I didn't read it. Yell at me. I mean, is there a mile limit, or they just get it the test drive for a year? I didn't see anything with miles. All I know is that you're driving a $75,000 SUV. No. I didn't hear the question, but the answer is no. I got to listen to the boss. But can I say, you get an X7 for an entire year. Imagine signing up to drive a test drive luxury car, but instead you're driving it for an entire year instead of an hour. So right now, through our partners, you are going to experience the BMW luxury like never before. Think about this. If you were going to get a lease or something like that, how much would you pay for something like that? I'm not a car guy, but I'm thinking a $75,000 lease is somewhere around $1,200 a month, give or take, right? Or call it $1,000 a month. Is it like $1,500? Yeah, like $1,500. You're going to get this for an entire year. Okay, yell at me if I'm missing anything or if I'm screwing this thing up. But they get it. Is there any stipulations of mileage or anything? Or they just test drive it? Because I don't want them to speak. Yeah, within reason. Don't be a fool and take it 70,000 miles across country. But I mean, like, reasonably, on average, we probably drive between 10 and 13,000 miles a year. But there's no real stipulations. Our partners at Champ want to raise the most money possible, and they're going to give you this thing right there for a year. So if you were going to pay a lease, which that money doesn't go towards Vaughn's vision, say it's $1,000, that would be $12,000 tonight. I'll start it super low. I'll start it at $4,000. That's a $380 payment, give or take, right? Who wants it for $4,000? $4,000, of course, yes. $4,000 now 45. $45 now 5. $5,000 now 55. 5 would give 55. $5,000's a bit now. Yes, 55. Can't let him bid on his own package. He just knows the value, and he's not going to let it go. 55 now 6. How is no one clapping for you at 6,000? Let's go. I'm letting it all hang out today. I'm having a good hair night. I'm losing my voice, but we're raising money. 6,000. 6,000 now 65. 6,000, what do you give 65? 6,000 now 65, what do you give? Yes. Oh, Juicy J back in the house with maybe an X7 coming in, girl. 6,500, thank you so much. You are awesome every year. 65 now 7. 65 now 7. 6,500, what do you give 7,000? I'll give you some dap, bro. Can I give you some dap? $7,000 right here. 7,000. Juicy Jen, just to let you know, you got outbid on the last one. Don't let it happen again. 7,000, what do you go 75, sister? 7,000, what do you give 75? I'm just going to say it. The boss is going 75. 7,500. Okay. Can we give him a round of applause because he's bidding on his own package that he donated? How is no one clapping for him at 7,500? But seriously, this is why he knows the value, and that is a steal. To drive that thing for less than $700 a month, are you kidding me? 7,500 now 8. 7,500 now 8. You go 8, we're doing chest bumps, just saying. You go 8, we're doing chest bumps. 7,500 now 8. $8,000 for the kids. That's a steal. 7,500 now 8. I really, She did it! Juicy Jen, $8,000. $8,085. Hey, I'm down if you are, okay? I'm down. I'll tell you this right now. If someone touches me with COVID, I'm not getting dirty. They're getting clean. Y'all don't know what I carry on the inside. $8,000. I'll do it. $8,000. What do you go? $85. If not, I'm down to chest bump, Jen. I'm down to break all the rules tonight, sister. $8,000 now. $85. Going once. $8,500. Let's go. $85 now. $9. $85 now. $9. Going once. What? Is it him? $9,000. Who is this? I must know. Someone dropping 9 G's from the back in the white tent? You gotta be somebody. This is the baller table. Who are you? May I approach or no? Thank you. What's your name?
Jay Stratton.
Jay Stratton. Smells like new car leather and expensive cologne, baby. Look at him go. Jay Stratton at 9 G's, 9,000. Will someone go 95 to take down Big J? We got Big J, we got Juicy J, we got 9,000, 9,500. Yell at me, if not, we're gonna close it out at 9,000 going once. 9,000, 9,500. How is no one clapping for you? Dang, 9,500. Can I just hang out with you guys after? This looks like a baller table right here. 9,500. How about $10,000? 95 now, 10,000. Big J, will he do it? He did it! How is this place not going bananas right now? That's $10,000 in the back. Big J, with respect, baby. Stratton, $10,000 now, 10,500 going once. 10,000 now, 10,500 going twice. Last call. Sold for $10,000. Wave that bitter paddle at me. That's 040. 040 at $10,000. All right, ladies. This is where you step up. Hey, for real, I know I've been saying this all night, for real, I'm going to go super fast because I'm falling behind. You guys are having too much of a good time. You're making me have so much fun. Here we go. This is our five-star wine getaway. Again, I'm gonna go super fast. Located just an hour north of San Francisco, you are gonna experience the best California wine country at the Fairmont Sonoma Mission Inn and Spa. All right, you're gonna have the geothermal fed pools. How cool is that? Saw a couple of those this summer. It's absolutely beautiful. Farm to table dining and access to the championship golf neighboring the Sonoma Golf Club. You're gonna get 3 days, 2 nights stay at the five-star Fairmont Sonoma Mission Inn. The spa and resort for two people. You're going to get breakfast every day. How cool is this? There are no expiration or blackout dates. No expiration or blackout dates. So for some reason, if this crap keeps lasting even past the election, there's no expiration. You can go whenever you want, 2022, 2023. All right? Girls, five-star getaway to wine country. The value of this package? Is $6,000, and I will start at super low. I'll start at $1,500. Who wants to go up north to wine? $1,500. Yes, of course. $15 now, $2,000. $2,000 now, $22. $22 now, $25. $22 over here. What do you give? $25. $22, the bid's now $25. Yell at me because I'm looking down. If someone goes to $25, we got it at $22. What do you give? $25. $25 now, $28. $2,500. We had $25. $28 in the back. Yes, at $2,800. $28 now, $3. $28 now, $3. $2,800, would he give $3,000? $28 now, $3. If not, she's getting it for $2,800, an extra $200, $3,000. $28 now once. $28 now, $3, twice. Anybody at $3,000? Last call. Wait, $3,000. How is no one clapping? Do I feel like, am I losing you guys here? Are we losing you raising money? $3,000. Hey, what was your name? You look so happy when you won it at $2,800. Yell your name at me. All right, listen, here's what we want to do. You had it at $2,800. If you go an extra $200, and if you match this gentleman at $3,000, we'll close it out. You'll get it at $3,000. That's an extra $200. Yes, 014, 014, and 080 at $3,000 apiece. That's $6,000. Give yourselves a round of applause. All right, how many Von Miller fans are in the house? Austin, where'd you say that hat was? Okay, this is baller, okay? Y'all know how much Von loves cowboy hats. I remember when he wore that outfit that's back by the backdrop, the step and repeat. So look at this. Von Miller, I'm afraid to touch it. I don't want to mess it up. So do they get this too?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, they get the whole thing. You get the briefcase, okay? You get everything, and it's upside down because you don't want to mess it. And I'm honestly, I don't want to touch it. I don't want to mess this thing up. So here's the deal with this Stetson. Y'all can look at the screen. We sold this last year, I think, for $5,000 or $6,000. So the oldest and most formidable hat company in the world has teamed up with Von Miller to offer you a once-in-a-lifetime bidding opportunity. Here's why it's once-in-a-lifetime. That's not just an auctioneer tagline. Stetson is proud to offer this true one-of-a-kind 1,000 times pure beaver and chinchilla cowboy hat. It is the only one ever made in Navy. Navy, which is to match Bronco color. Now, if y'all be honest that no cowboy hats, you've never seen a dark Navy cowboy hat. I don't care what you say. I've been around my whole life. This is dark Navy, and check it out. On the side is an eye-catching, and by the way, if you're serious about bidding this, you can come up and look at it while we're bidding, so you know it's the legit and the real thing. Eye-catching number 58, 14-carat gold buckle set with a beautiful inset of 3/4-carat diamonds. So the 58 on the side is engraved in diamonds. It's a natural leather sweatband customized with Von's vision. You get the case, you get everything again. We've done it in the past for $5,000, $6,000. I'll start at Super Bowl. I'll start at $2,000. Absolutely, ma'am. Come here. I'll grab your, there you go. So pick it up. Feel free to look at it. Yes, ma'am. You get the case as well. So I'll start it at $2,000, $2,000. Again, Von had a similar hat that he wore, but this is the only dark Navy they've ever made, Stetson has ever made. $2,000. Would he give $2,000? Yes, $2,000 over here. Now $25. He's got it at $2,000. Would he give $25? $2,000's a bid now. $25. Would he give $25? If not, you're gonna steal it. $2,000. Oh snap! You're gonna get this thing. $2,000. I'm flipping it over. $2,000. Now $2,500 going once. $2,500 over here. How's no one clapping for you? $25 now $3,000. $2,500. Would he give $3,000? $25 now $3,000 going once. $25 now $3,000 going twice. Last call. Sold for, oh snap, $3,000. Respectfully, $3,000 now $32. $3,000, what do you give $32? I'll only go in $200 increments if you want. $3,000 going once. $3,000 now $32 going twice. Last call. Sold for $3,000. Bidder number. Wave that bitter paddle at me, please. 093. Give a round of applause for 093. I'm down. You want a chest bump? Let's do this. $2,500. Let's go, baby. Give him a round of applause. There you go. Hit that. Hit that scotch. Here we go. Come on. Chest bump. $2,500. Bam! Give a round of applause for $2,500. All right, stay with me. We're right at the very end. We got about 4 more items. I need you guys. Von needs you guys. Stay with us. So appreciate you staying with us so late and making it happen. Tonight has been phenomenal, and we're going to give you a chance to basically recreate tonight at your house. You are going to experience the world of whiskey like never before. So check this out. You and 9 of your friends are going to enjoy a guided whiskey tour tasting in, I shouldn't say tour, a whiskey tasting in your home, led by one of Boulder Spirits' top ambassadors. And to add to the experience, did you guys not enjoy the phenomenal food tonight by Footers Catering? Can we give a round of applause for Footers? Footers Catering is going to serve you a four-course dinner to pair with the spirits that are prepared by the culinary experts. So you, nine of your friends, so 10 people total in your home, you're going to get the guided whiskey tasting. You're going to get the catering four-course meal by Footers, premium tasting of Boulder spirits for 10 people, guided by a distilling professional, beer and wine included. And if that's not enough, do we have it on us, Austin? They're going to give you a complimentary Denver Broncos football. So that bag that you have, you're basically going to give your guests the signed football by Von Miller. So each person is going to get a signed football by Von, and you can take the location of your choice. So at your house, if you want to do it at like the clubhouse where you live, wherever, you pick. 10 people, four-course meal, whiskey, catering, everything. Excuse me, the value of this is $3,000. I got to start at super low. I'll start at $500. That's well worth it. Of course, $500 now $7, $7 now $9, $900 now $1,000, $1,000 now $12, $1,000 over here now $12, $1,200 now $15, $1,200, what do you get $15, $1,200 now $15, how about $14, $1,200 now $14, $1,200, what do you get $14, $1,200 over here now $14, $1,200, yes, $1,400. Let's keep the clapping going. $1,200, next bid, $1 million, $1 million. He did it. Just kidding. I'll do $200. So what were we at? 14, now 16. 1,600, now 18. 16, what do you give 18? 16, yes, 18 now two. 18 now two. Come on, bro. 10 of your friends, $200 a piece. That's well worth it. Just the dinner alone. And they come to you. They cater it. Everyone gets a football. 1,800, now 2,000. 1,800, what do you give 2,000? 1,800, now two. You're still getting a smoking deal. It's worth three. She's got it at 1,800, now 2,000, going once. $2,000. A newbie. I haven't seen you raise it tonight. Feels good, doesn't it? Does it feel good? Who are you with tonight? Are you rolling Han Solo or are you with somebody? No? It's Han Solo? Dude, you know what that means? That means you and me can invite our friends and we could have it at your house. Thank you so much. Give a round of applause for 2,000, but it's not over. 2,000 now 22. 2,000 now 22. 2,000, I'm just going to let you know. You're sitting at Juicy Jen's table, and she's pretty much undefeated at this, so don't let her down. Okay? Don't let her down. 2,200. 2,000 now 22. 2,000 now 22. 2,000, what do you give 22? If not, the newbie is getting it at $2,000. Going once. $2,000. Going twice. Last call, sold for $2,000 to 127. 127. All right, my friends. This is really cool. For those of you who like travel, this is the North American experience. You are going to visit your favorite region of North America in style by staying. You're going to stay. This is not a resort. This is a private luxury residence. You are going to get 4 nights, 5 days, and you pick where you want to go. Again, private residence at either New York City, San Francisco, Chicago, Miami, New Orleans, Nashville, Seattle, Sonoma Valley, Boston, Montreal, Toronto, Charleston, San Diego, and or Santa Fe. Each place, private residence fits 4 to 6 people. 2 to 3 bedrooms, depending on where you stay. So New York might have 2 bedrooms, but Charleston might have 3. But 4 to 6 people, very accommodating. This company is very accommodating, and you can pick your destination in over 14 different places. The value of this, they run about $1,000 a night. So the value is just under $5,000. I'll start at super low. I'll start at $1,500. 1,500, yes, 15 now 2. 2,000 now 25. 25, yes, 25. 2,000 now 25. 2,000, what do you give 25? It's an extra $500. We have 2,000 now 25. Yes, 25. It's a bidder number 25. Look at that. 2,500 now 3,000. 2,500 the bid now 3,000. If not, I'm going to close it out at 2,500. Going once. $3,000. Hey, you've been bidding all night. Can we give you a round of applause? Thank you so much. 3,000 now 33. 3,000 now 3,300. Look at this. All of these different places you can go and you can pick. 3,300 private residence. OG. This thing is bomb. 3,000 now 33 going once. 3,000 now 33 going twice. Last call. Sold for $3,000. Let me see that bidder paddle, please. 080-080-3000. Stay with me. We got four more. Who wants to go to the Super Bowl? Super Bowl with Von Miller. Super Bowl is the greatest sporting event of all time. You are going to go to the Super Bowl this year, February 7th, 2021. You're going to go to Tampa. You are going to stay in a Tampa hotel right in the heart of Tampa. You are going to get a meet and greet with Von Miller that weekend. And for those of you who know, Von is pretty much the best defensive player in the NFL, which means a lot of people like him and a lot of people kick it with him. So when you do that meet and greet with Von, odds are you're going to be meet and greeting with a lot of other people as well. You're going to get two tickets to Super Bowl. Oh, God, what are we on, 55? What's LV? 55? 55? Super Bowl 55, you're going to get two tickets. Meet and greet with Von, three-night stay in Tampa. The value of this is $16,000. I'll start it low, and I will go fast. Low and fast. I'll start it at $7,000. $7,000. Seven now eight. Eight now nine. Nine now 10. 8,000 over here, would you give 10,000? 8,000 now 10. Losing my voice. Stay with me. 8,000, would you give 10,000? If not, I got to close it out right here at 8,000. 8,000 now 10. 8,000 now 10 going once. You'll get it at 10 too. Meet and greet alone is worth that. 8,000 now 10 twice. Last call. Right there, I'll close it out. $8,000. Give a round of applause. We're moving on. Von Miller game-worn cleats. So Von gave you some of his game-worn cleats. So you're going to here's your chance to own a piece of NFL history. Von Miller's very own game-worn cleats, signed by the future Hall of Famer himself. And as a cherry on top, we are going to give you an autographed Von Miller jersey. Look at that, Austin. You having a good time?
Having a great time.
Fantastic. Here we go. Von Miller, signed jersey, signed cleats. That's bomb. That is bomb right there. So you're going to get signed cleats, signed jersey from the one and only Von Miller himself. The value of this, I don't know, it's priceless. I'll start it super low. I'll start at $500. Who wants the cleats and the jersey at $500? $500, of course, now $750. $500, now $750. $500, what do you give? $750. $500, now $750 in the back. Give her a round of applause. $750. $750, now $1,000. $750, would he give $1,000? $750, now $1,000. The cleats, the jersey. The jersey alone is worth more than $1,000. $750, now $1,000. $750, would he give $1,000? If not, you're getting a steal at $750. $1,000, going once. $750, now $1,000, going twice. $1,000. And to number one, give her a round of applause, $1,000. Hey, here's what I'll do, because I want to respect you. You had the bid at $750, and when I was saying $1,000, you were going to outbid yourself at $1,000. So here's what I'll do. He's got an extra pair of cleats. I'll give it to her for $1,000. You go $1,000, we'll close it out. That'll be $2,000. Wave at me if you do it for $1,000. Yes, 007 and 001 at $1,000. Give them a round of applause. My gosh, we're almost done. I'm sad. I've been doing this a long time, and I do a lot of events in a year, about 70 to 80. This is only my third live event this year. I'm so happy to be with you guys. And Saturday, I was in Orange County, and they tried to do this virtual thing, and it was a nightmare. So this is the best time I've had all year, and I don't want this night to end. God, I love you guys. Can I spend the night? The guy that had the dinner? Can I spend the night? I know, seriously, right? Here we go. Cancun Paradise Vacation. It's our second-to-last auction item. Visitors seeking a relaxing beach vacation is going to delight in Cancun's unparalleled tropical beauty, most famous for its long, white sandy beaches, stunning turquoise water, and the vibrant nightlife. Cancun also boasts a rich history and breathtaking sights. You're going to get 5 nights in a deluxe king room, lagoon view at the Westin Spa Cancun. You're going to get daily breakfast. You are going to get round-trip airfare. You are going to get private booking and concierge service. So again, basically a week. You're going to get 5 nights. So 6 days, 5 nights in a deluxe king for two people. The value is $5,000. I'll start it at $2,200. 22, yes, 22, now 25. 22, now 25. 25, now 27. 25, now 27. 25, now 27. 25, 27, if not. Oh, snap, we got an intertable scrimmage right here. 27. 27, now 29. Do you guys know each other? This is so fun and uncomfortable at the same time. 27, he's got a 27, now 29. 27, what do you go, 29. 27, now 29, going once. 29, she did it. Oh, snap. What are you going to do? 29, now 32. 29, now 32. 2,900 going once. I'm going to close it out. 2,900 going twice. Last call. 30, what did I say, 32? 3,200 right here. Let's give him a clap for 3,200. 32, now 36. 32, now 36. I'll make you a deal. If both of you go 36, we'll close it out. We'll raise $7,200. As of right now, he's got it at 32. If you want to outbid him, you go 36, and then the pressure's on him. But he owns it at 32. 32, will you go 36? Going once, and it won't go higher than 36. 32, now 36. It won't go higher than 36. 32, 36, going once. I think she's out. 32, now 36, going twice. Last call. Smoking deal sold for $3,200 to 134. 134 at $3,400. Last item. Have you guys had a good time? Dude, for real, we're putting in work tonight, baby. You guys are doing an awesome job. Seriously, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. You guys have been very, very generous tonight. And this is our last live auction item. This is a luxury getaway to Boca Raton. You are going to enjoy one of the most elegant resorts on the Florida East Coast. The iconic Boca Raton Resort and Club at the Waldorf Astoria, featuring two championship 18-hole courses and infinite amenities. You are going to get 3 days, 2 nights for two guests at a gorgeous suite at the legendary Boca Raton Resort. It includes access to the Boca Raton Club, and you are going to enjoy either a round of golf for each person or a 50-minute massage per person. So travel dates are super open. Boca Raton, you get the suite, you get the private club, you get the golf and the massage. Value is $6,500. I'll start at super low. I'll start at 2,000. Last item, let's make it happen. 2,000, yes, now 25. 2,000, now 25. 2,000, the bid's now 25. Let's not leave it at 2,000 on the last one. Someone go 25. 2,000, now 25. Yell at me, and then we're playing heads or tails. 2,000, 25, going once. 2,000, now 25, going twice. Last call, 2,500. You got one clap. I'll clap for you. 2,500 now. Yeah, 2,500 now, 28. 25 now, 28. If not, I'm going to close it out. We're going to play heads or tails. 2,500 going once. 25 now, 28 going twice. Last call. Sold for 2,500 at 025. 025.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, can we call the first lady up here? First lady to the stage, the one and only Von Miller's mama is in the house. You want to help her?
Can I hold your hand or no? Just want to make sure.
Deal. Can we give it up for the first lady is in the house? All right. We are going to have some fun. This is the last item of the night. And then I'm going to bring in your awesome MC who has completely knocked it out of the park tonight. Everyone who has one of these beads, stand up. We're going to play some heads or tails. Heads or tails. Don't leave. This is over in about 5 minutes. Heck yeah. Is he here? He's here. The guy with the beautiful legs and the wonderful beard. Your kicker, Brandon McManus. And we're live. How you doing, brother? Hold on. We can't hear you. Let us get the volume real quick. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mr. McManus. There we go.
Can you hear me?
Now we can. How are you?
Good. Thank you for that awesome introduction. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. You had a great game this week. You have the most gorgeous legs in the NFL. How are you feeling?
I feel good. I feel good. Appreciate everyone showing up today, supporting Vaughn's vision. Vaughn, obviously, as everyone knows, does a tremendous job here in the Denver community. And, you know, any way I can support him, you know, I'm here, always here to do that.
You're awesome, man. I'll be quick, real quick. But I did notice last year when I met you, when you came to this last year, it really seemed like not only are you guys seeming like you and Vaughn are like real friends, right? Like you guys are real good friends, aren't you?
Yeah, no, we are. You can ask his mom right there next to you. But and Vaughn's actually the godfather to my second twin. Vaughn was the number two pick in the draft. So I asked him which one he'd like to be. So he chose the number two, the twin that was born second. So, no, Vaughn's been tremendous to me. And you know, I've been checking in on him and his injury and his rehab. And just trying to keep him up in good spirits, you know, knowing how great he's going to come back and how hard he worked this offseason to train and everything, and look forward to an incredible cap that he could put to the end of his career with coming back from this injury.
That's awesome. Hey, can we all tell, hey, before we let you go, do you want to hear the crowd tell you how much they love you because you were here last year and you were awesome? Should I get them all to scream it to you? Here we go. Hey, how about on the count of three, we scream, I love you, Brandon. One, two, three. Freaking love you. You're the man. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
All right. Have a good one. Thank you. Thank you.
You too.
Hey, we also have, real quick before we do heads or tails, we have one more private video from a Grammy winner. This is the founder of the Black Eyed Peas. Are we going to roll that video? How cool is this? Are we good?
Hey, yo, what's up? My name is Apple the App, the co-founder of the Black Eyed Peas. And I'd like to thank everyone here tonight for supporting Vaughn Miller and Vaughn's vision. For me, growing up poor in the Philippines meant not having regular access to eye care. This made school next to impossible to thrive in. Or at least that's what I tell my parents when I had bad grades. Just kidding, y'all. But truly, it's amazing what the Vaughn's vision is doing to make sure every child in the community can see all the incredible things the world has to offer. So enjoy the rest of your night, and thank you for supporting Vaughn's vision and gifting the gift of sight. Thank you all very much.
God bless him. Apple the App right there, Black Eyed Peas. Here we go. Oh, did we drop it? Here, I'll get it for you. Okay. So Mama is going to flip the coin. The last person standing is going to get this signed, authentic Vaughn Miller Broncos helmet. Does anybody have more than three chains? All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to go as fast as possible. Really, really need you guys. 5 more minutes. Stay with us. We got this, and then one more quick thing, and we are out. So for the people sitting down not playing, I promise you, I need your help. Watch the people standing up, for real, because I know this is charity. But people freaking cheat when the helmet's on the line. I'm telling you, I've been doing this a long time. It happens. It's weird. But we want the winners to win. So if you're sitting down, watch the people that are standing up. It's super simple. Hand on your head or hand on your tail. And there's a lot of you playing, so we got to go fast. Hand on your head or hand on your tail. If you have your hand on your head and she flips a tail, you're out. If you have more than one bead, you just take the one bead off, place it on the table. Please use the honor system. Those that are not playing, please watch. For real, for real. All right, here we go. Everybody, hand on your head or hand on your tail. First one is?
Heads.
Heads. Tails, sit down. Tails, sit down. All right. Now, hand on your head or hand on your tail. Everybody ready? People sitting down, watch. Make a decision. Head, tail. Here it is.
Heads.
Heads again. Tails, have a seat or take a bead off. Here we go. We're still not even halfway there. Hand on your head, hand on your tail. Hand on your head, hand on your tail. And it is.
Heads.
Heads again. Three in a row. how many will go tails this time? And she's legitimately flipping it too. Hand on your head, hand on your tail. Round four. And it is
heads
again. Snap. I feel like we're at the roulette table and we just keep pressing our luck. Here we go. We're down to about 20%. Hand on your head, hand on your tail. Make your decision. Here it is.
Tails.
Heads, have a seat. Wave at me if you're still in. A lot of people. Here we go. Hand on your head, hand on your tail. Round six is
heads.
Five heads, one tail. Here we go. Next people up. Hand on your head, hand on your tail. Sign Von Miller Bronco helmet on the line, and it is
tails.
Heads, have a seat. Wave at me if you're still in it. Wave at me if you're still in it. One, two. Come up here if you're still in it. Hurry, hurry, hurry. And hey, when you walk, please do not trip on those openings on the ground. We do not want anybody to be hurt. We want everyone to be safe. Please watch your step. And right here where the cords pass through, right up here in the center stage. Dad, we have the same hair. Oh my gosh, I thought you were my dad. Dad, is that you? God, I miss you. Gosh. All right, here we go. Who's in it? Come on up here. We got three gentlemen. No ladies? No ladies? We got one, two, three. Oh, come up here, baby. Let's go. Let's go, kid. Everyone's going to be rooting for you. What's your name? My name's Matthew, too. Dude, you're the freaking man. Love you, bro. All right, here we go. Oh, look at that. Dad, I love you. Matthew, I think this is your night, bro. I think this is your night. Here we go. Hand on your head, hand on your tail. Where are you going? You're going heads, you're going tails, you're going heads. And it is.
Heads.
The tail is out. Thank you so much. Here we go. Matthew, you got two. He's got one. I'm going to put you in the power position. Okay, you pick, and whatever you pick, he's got to do the opposite. It's on you. What are you doing, Matthew? You're going tails? Here we go. He's going tails, which means your head. All right. And it is?
Tails.
Let's go! Matthew! Hey.
You got to say, I love you, Mama.
Love you, Mama.
I love you, Mama. Matthew did it! Hey, come here real quick. Come up here. Let me grab your wrist. I don't touch your hand. I want you to stand in front of this locker. I want you to raise that helmet up, and our photographer's going to take an awesome picture. Put a big smile on your face. Matthew, you're the man. Everybody loves you. Go take that home and wear it. God bless you, Matthew. Here we go. Hey, have we had a good time tonight? Last thing. I need everybody to hold your bitter paddles up. This is our last thing. Everybody hold your bitter paddles up. It's not, I'm not going to trick you or nothing. One more thing. Bitter paddles up. We are going to try to raise an extra about $10,000 right now. Here's what we're going to do. This is called the paddle drop. Don't worry, you're not going to be put in unless you want to. Our volunteers are coming around right now with a basket for you to drop it in. If you drop your bitter paddle in the basket, you donated $100. We are going to bring those bitter paddles up here. If everyone gave $100, that would be about $10,000. We're going to bring it up here. Our lovely MC is going to draw the number out. The winner is going to get $500 gift card to Hapa Sushi and a bottle of Boulder Spirits bourbon. So the value of this is just under $1,000, and you're going to get it for $100. So volunteers, come around. DJ Xanity, can you play us some beats? Play us some beats, baby. And then drop your bitter paddle in the basket or the bucket. Volunteers are making their way right now. Thank you so much. And thank you all for giving tonight. This has been phenomenal. Here we go. We're going to go quick. We're going to go quick. Hand your bitter paddle to our volunteers. You can turn it up a little bit.
yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number, I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, thunder.
Anybody, thunder. Do we miss anybody? Wave your bitter paddle at me. $100 for a $1,000 value. Matthew, you should drop your bitter paddle in. Tonight's your night, baby. $100. All right, we're going to bring them forward. Anybody else? $100. I don't want to miss anybody. I don't want to miss anybody. All right, we good? Susie, you have them all? We got a couple more here. Here we go. We are going to pull your number right now. Someone's getting $500 to Hapa Sushi. Someone is getting a bottle of Boulder Spirits bourbon. Here we go. Is this your mic?
Yes, it is.
The winner is
114.
114, where are you at?
Tent. Somebody's happy. Nice. Hey, it's your dad again. No,
dad?
Different dad.
It's my dad. Hey, seriously. Hey, honestly, tonight was an honor. I love you guys. God bless you. My
name
is Matt Rogers.
You can come,
thank you so much. Susie, they're all yours, sister.
Matthew, thank you so
thank
much.
You.
Hey, let's hear from Matthew. Great job. Holy cow, is he awesome? Gets up here for a good hour plus and loses his voice and raises a lot of money for Vaughn's Vision. The silent auction, I think it's closed. Is the silent auction now closed? Okay, it is closed. I thought I heard somebody yelling over by a table that they won the Cal Ripken ball. Good job over there. All right, if you missed out on a live auction item, you can still show your support with a donation through GiveSmart on your phone. If you think you might be the winner of an auction item tonight, make sure you check out with the GiveSmart staff. And you guys, kudos to everybody that came out tonight. Thank you to everybody that was watching virtually as well. Big event, probably the first one for most of us to be out in this crazy 2020 that we have. So thank you so much for coming out. You know Vaughn appreciates it. His family appreciates it. They're always so great about being out here and the people that do all the work behind the scenes too. So give yourselves a round of applause for coming out tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you to Signature and Centennial Airport and the great staff that catered tonight as well. So have a great night. Thank you again for giving, and we'll see you again next year.